look at these numbers of excellence.
Philadelphia Flyers versus Minnesota Wild.
Of having so much that has gone on in his life with Josh Harding. Perhaps we'll get to that, but more important matters right now. The play of the athletes in front of him. Pominville tried to chip it along, led on, and Parise settled it down. Parise wanted to find Koivu. Eventually it comes along to him, and he rode off Demonen. Meanwhile, along near Voracek. Voracek fed it behind, and Demonen can settle it down there. Parise hunts him down, so it's quickly along to Colbert. To Demonen. And cranked back in. Harding knows that he's going to see the best from the Flyers here down the bumpy road to the finish. Flyers saw the Wild strike for two in 57 seconds in this period. Here's a chance for Giroux, and that one just scooped up very calmly by Harding.
Well, Doc, you were talking about the personal travails for Josh Harding, and you think about battling through MS. I mean, not easy. I was talking to Michael Rupp during that last TV timeout, and he said, you know, the interesting thing about Harding, and I was just trying to share it with the viewers, he's an amazing athlete. Rupp says, you play all these other sports with our team here in Minnesota, basketball, football, baseball, softball. He says, Harding kicks everybody's butt in every sport.
Here is Luke Shen with a shot that is turned aside. It is a source of annoyance to many of us who aren't athletes at all that somebody can be so good at all of them. But that happens a lot, particularly with hockey players and golf.
Yes.
Poked ahead. Same motion, I guess, and the same strength that they have. Laid back on now to Shen. Shen tried to trickle one through. And from the slot, a shot is answered by Harding. Oh, my. Luke Shen, after Braden Shen had his try. On a crossbar drive, and a save made by Emery on Heatley.
And that's Danny Heatley, who's still got his hands. He can really still shoot the puck.
Shift change, and he will come into the open gate near Pierre as this is wheeled back out again and away from Niederreiter, who will chase it down. Niederreiter rocked a little bit there by Mark Streit. Taken to the outside and led on to Brodziak, and a save by Emery in a cover. This would be very lopsided were it not for the cat-like reflexes of the goalie for the Flyers. And it remains a zero at the other end because of some strength coming from Harding as the Flyers have tested him more in the third.
Well, Danny Heatley's been a 50-goal scorer in this league. And like I said, he may not be the fastest guy in the league anymore, but he still has his hands. There's Exhibit A of his hands. Great job by Ray Emery tracking that puck. And here's the second chance. Mitchell up front, great opportunity, and Ray Emery shuts the door. Seeing some unbelievable goaltending from Ray Emery and some very solid goaltending from Josh Harding. Doc, 1984, that man was born in Regina, Saskatchewan. 1985, Ryan Getzlaff was born in Regina, Saskatchewan. Two amazing athletes from the same small town in the Prairie Province of Saskatchewan.
I've heard of Regina a lot, but I haven't looked up the population. I should, but it's small.
It's not very large, though. They just won the Grey Cup, by the way, and Ryan Getzlaff's brother, Chris, was a wide receiver that scored touchdowns in the game. Grey Cup is like the Super Bowl for Canadian football.
I believe he was given the MVP, the Canadian MVP, anyway. Mike Milbury took notice of that, by the way. It was funny to watch. He and Keith Jones sparring back and forth. The American versus the other guy. Well, here's Stoner now with his team ahead by two.
Well, an American quarterback was a quarterback that was getting them the balls, Devin Durant. So there you go.
Here is Colbert. Some pretty heady work done on him. More shoving there too. Meanwhile, this kicked back along. It was the work of Pominville on the forecheck. Meanwhile, this is dumped on back. Settled down and controlled by Hartnell, given back on to Couturier, and a shot into the catching glove of Harding. You had the sense that it was going to at least simmer a little more and get some bubbles going up from the cauldron, but not over yet, because the Flyers have more important business at hand, and that's getting back into it. They're down by two.
Part of the problem for Philadelphia, and you've been saying it, one and done.